One of the uses of Mac is to have Windows running on top of it. Even though it is not the most popular choice or effective choice, still people have to use it because of several reasons. One of the reasons could be if there are softwares which have drivers only for Windows, we need to have Windows running on the Mac so that we can use that software. We can actually set up Windows either as part of the dual boot, or we can actually have a virtualization software and then create a virtual machine on top of it. As part of this video, I will be explaining different virtualization software alternatives, and I'll be choosing one, and I'll be going ahead and setting up that software and then deploy Windows based virtual machine on top of it. The first choice when it comes to setting up a virtualization software on Mac or any other OS platform is VirtualBox. The main advantage of VirtualBox is it is free. We just have to set up this virtualization software and we can actually get ISO image of whatever operating system we want to run, and we can go ahead and set up on top of it. However, the disadvantage of using VirtualBox, especially by deploying Windows on top of it, is there is hardly any integration between the core Mac features with this VirtualBox. The second alternative software, which is a licensed version, is VMware's Fusion. So if you are familiar with VMware's suite of products for Windows we have VMware Workstation, for Mac we have VMware Fusion. So you have to install VMware Fusion and then use Windows ISO image and set up a virtual machine with Windows operating system using this virtualization software called as VMware Fusion. And the third alternative and the most popular choice when it comes to setting up of Windows on top of Mac as virtual machine is Parallels. It is a licensed product like VMware Fusion. It is a bit expensive. However, it has a very tight integration with Mac, and you should be able to use some of the core features of Mac while running Windows on top of Parallels based virtual machine. Let's see how we can actually set up Parallels and then Windows on top of Parallels. So here I am downloading the free trial and then saying download now. It comes with a 14-day trial. I am clicking on OK. I have a older version in my old Mac. If I like this newer version, I will definitely buy the license. For now, I will be demonstrating using the trial version. So here I can say download Parallels Desktop. You can see it is downloading. Actually, there is a download already running, so I can cancel this. Yes, this download is almost done. We can actually go to this folder where the download happened. Let us clean this up, which is a partial download which was done accidentally. Now let us actually use this DMG file and set up Parallels on this Mac. I just double clicked it and it started installing. We just have to double click here, say open, accept, and then we have to enter the password here, say OK. It is saying open the Mac OS security preferences and click allow next to Parallels International GmbH. Once the parallel components are loaded, Parallels Desktop will start automatically. So we just have to click on open security preferences, and you can see the option here. Even when we set up Google Drive file stream, it actually prompts something like this only. So we just have to say allow, and then we can close this. And now Parallels Desktop is starting. The beauty of Parallels is, as it is started, it actually let you install Windows directly. We can just say install Windows here, and it will take care of downloading the Windows operating system with a trial version, and you should be able to set up on your Mac very easily. Once the download is done, it will even take care of installation seamlessly. We just have to complete the setup process once the download and installation is done. And also, Parallels have something called as Parallels Tools. Once they are set up, we can easily access the Mac-based files as part of the Windows virtual machine. And I'll be demonstrating it once the download and installation is done. As the size of the file is almost 5 GB, it will take some time to download completely. Once the download is done, I will resume the demonstration and I'll be recording to complete the installation process. Now the installation is done, or download as well as installation is done, and it is taking care of setting up the Windows as a virtual machine using Parallels. It is actually taking care of copying Windows files and then getting files ready for installation. Then it will install the features. It will take care of any updates that are pending, and then it will actually finish the setup process. It will again take some time, and once it is done, we will actually resume the recording. It has completed the setup process. I think now it is actually bringing up the Windows-based virtual machine using Parallels. Now it is actually taking care of bringing up the Windows-based virtual machine using Parallels on the Mac. It will still take some more time to complete the setup process and let us log in into the Windows-based virtual machine. So it is saying this might take several times. Don't turn off your PC. So don't take any actions on your PC until the setup process is done. And also make sure it is connected to the power so that it will not go down because of the insufficient power in your battery. So the installation is complete. The beauty of using Parallels is it will actually take the Mac credentials itself to log in. You don't need to set up a different user to actually log into this Windows-based PC or virtual machine on top of your Mac if it is set up using Parallels. That being said, it is actually asking us to sign into the Parallels account so that it can authenticate us. So let me log into it using my Google account. I already have a license. However, that license is for older version of Parallels, and hence it might not be able to use that license here, because the latest version have integration with touchpad or touch bar, which comes with the latest version of Mac. So I don't know whether it took the existing Parallels license or not, but as of now it doesn't have any issues, because even if my license is invalid, I am in the 14-day trial period. That being said, now it is logged into this Windows machine, and you can see here the desktop, which is there for our Mac. All the files are visible here. You can see Adobe After Effects, Adobe Media Encoder, Camtasia, Microsoft Edge, which is just installed as part of this, and Zoom.us. And also if you go to the desktop on the Mac, it also contains almost the same files. So it is actually using some of the features of the Mac directly. Even if you go to the File Explorer here, and if you go to the Downloads, this Downloads is whatever is the downloads in the Mac. The reason why I use Parallels is it has tight integration between the virtual machine and the host, which is running on Apple's Mac OS. So that's why I prefer Parallels over other virtualization softwares. That being said, don't worry too much if you don't understand all these things. You just start using it and you will be able to understand all these cool features, and you should be good to go. The reason why I have set up Parallels and then Windows on top of it is, going forward I want to create several videos so that the veterans who are using Windows can easily transition to Mac by comparing and contrasting all those features which you typically use in Windows, and then what are the relevant tools when it comes to Mac. For that reason, I just want to have both. That's why I actually installed Windows on my Mac itself, and I will be demonstrating the differences. For example, in Windows, we use File Explorer to access the directories and files. In Mac, there is no File Explorer, but it has something called as Finder. So we can easily compare and contrast the features that are available in Windows File Explorer and the Finder, and understand those key features of Finder which can improve your productivity. Like that, there are many other aspects which I want to cover over a period of time. That's why I have set up Windows using Parallels on my Mac, which will facilitate me to actually compare and contrast some of the key features between Mac as well as Windows.